everybody. This is Dare from Daru Steak Saltwater Adventures. Today, I'm upgrading my canister filter. The canister filter I have initially over here is the Cascade 1000, which I think the capacity is 100 gallons. So I have two of them on both sides over here. So what I'm doing today is I am upgrading to this CF 500 UV aquarium canister filter. It looks very interesting. It has a UV light in there, which will make the water super clean. And it has four layers, so you can put so many filter media in there, which I like. I'm excited about this. And let's see what it says it comes with. Oh, yeah. All those components and everything. Okay, that's very interesting. Ooh, look at that. So I'm gonna try this out and see how it looks. Let's unbox this. I don't know, I'm ripping everything apart to see what it looks like. Come on. Okay. Most people don't like canister filter because like, oh, ammonia. You have so many ammonia and all that crap in there. I can't do like what do you call it, like a sump in here because of my stand, so I have to make use of what I have. So that's why I'm going with a canister filter, you know. And the 125 gallons on the aquarium, and I'm always scared because of tempered glass. If you drill, it might crack, so you gotta use what you have. So looking at the canister filter. Ooh, looks very, very big. It's a big boy. This is a big boy over here. Oh, crap. I almost dropped my camera. Look at this big boy. He is a big boy. Look at this big boy over here. Oh, my God. This boy is big. He's huge. Oh, my God. Let me rip this apart. Can you use one hand? If everybody can see. Yeah, I'm the only one filming. Nobody helping me out. I can do this. I can do this myself. Look at this bad boy. This bad boy is for, I think it's up to, it says over here, is for up to 9 to 175 gallons. Woohoo! And then it says built-in 9-watt UV sterilization, zero bypass. Woohoo! 525 gallon per hour. Ooh, 1 year warranty. Okay, mechanical, ultraviolet, biological. And it says adjustable flow control. Woohoo! I'm excited about this. About time. So, what we're gonna do is I'm gonna open it up to see the components, the layers. And then we have to clean everything. But I just want to see how it looks inside. It's just like a normal canister. Okay, so let's just pull this joker. Oh, look at this. This is so nice. Come on, let me not break it. it cost me about 200 and something bucks. I think 212 bucks. That's the UV light. Oh, look at that. And then you can see the layers. Ooh, this is interesting. Bio balls. Okay. Oh, carbon, okay, and filter floss, okay. It looks very, very easy, fantastic. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and open some of them, rinse them, and then I'll be back shortly. Stay tuned. So what I'm doing is I'm just gonna rinse all this in the bucket, and as well as with the carbon and the rest of what's inside there, because you know, you just want to make sure everything is clean, and then we'll see how everything goes. Okay, so I've already rinsed all the media, the carbon, and as well as the what do you call it, the mechanical filtration, those rocks and the bio balls. So I've already rinsed it. Everything's good to go. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to look at the length that I have with the original length of the tube I have in here from the Cascade. I'll measure it out, cut it, and then plug it. And then we should be good to go. So all the instructions, they pretty look straightforward. So I have this is the instruction manual. So I can read that if I like, but I think I should be able to figure this out. And then, this looks very, very interesting. What the heck is this? Anyway, I'll figure it out. Okay, stay tuned. So looking at the manual, there are two options. I can have it go all the way down, or I can have it go across. So that, you know, it depends on what you like, but I think I'm going to go with option one, this one over here. Okay, let's see how this goes. This is very interesting because it says this piece over here is the skimmer cup. Ooh, you can use this as a skimmer too. Look at that. Okay, so I'm following the steps on how to install what I need to do, and we'll be back. Looks as if I got this wrong. So there are two options. So the inlet is this way, or you can have it with the surface skimmer, but you can have the option of using the pipes to splash, or you can just have the surface agitation option, option B. I'm gonna go with 1B, and then I might go either with 2B or 2A. Let's see which one is easier. So I went with the other option just to have that way, and this one that way. So what I'm going to do next is just measure the length of the tube, and then we'll plug it in. I'm not going with the skimmer option. That's too much work for me. I like easy stuff. So we'll see how it goes. So I'm trying to see the height, which one is taller. Definitely this is taller, so the tubing has to be a little bit shorter on this one, not as long as this one. So what I did was, you know, I always, for safety, I always put a little bucket in there. We don't want to make sure anything leaks. And then I've already placed it in there, so it's the tubing that I need to get to see the size of the tubing, and then we're gonna plug and see how it goes. So I noticed that this brace over here is a problem for me to hang on the back of that, whatever you call it over here. So I'm just gonna take this off like I did that one. You can see I took it off. So I'm gonna do the same thing for this one, okay, for the intake. Okay, so I've connected the valves in, and that's what they look like in the tank. So I'm gonna go ahead and start this joker up and let's see what happens. So the instruction indicates that I need to loosen the nut over here and then pour water until the hose is full before I start the pump. So I've taken off the screws and I'm about to fill water in it. Hope I don't make a mess. Said until the hose is full of water. Yes, I need to put more water. So after filling it up, I had to close the tap, the top knob, and then I started the canister filter. So you can see it's working. Water is coming off. Woo! This was a lot of work, I'm telling you, only me. But it's working. So I think the main purpose of pouring water from the inlet is to fill up the canister. But I'm surprised, one day they allowed me to press this over here. Duh. I was trying that, but I noticed that water wasn't coming in. So it's pumping, it's working right now. So woohoo! So let's see, I'm gonna give it a few days and see how clear this tank is gonna be. So we'll see what happens. So right now is working, so we'll see what happens next. So stay tuned. We're gonna see, did I get my camera right? Yeah, we're gonna see what happens, if it's gonna clear out. I don't think I need that. Well, sort of I do. It's gonna clear out eventually. Look at that Aptasia over there, Lord have mercy. I'm trying to get a copper band butterfly. So we'll see how this goes. I hope everybody enjoyed this video, but sorry, it was only one man job, so I had to do everything myself. You know, I hope everybody's having a fantastic day, fantastic week. See you next time. New canister! Bye bye!